Jerry González was born on June 5, 1949 and died on October 1, 2018. He was an American bandleader, trumpeter and percussionist of Puerto Rican descent. Together with his brother, bassist Andy González, he played an important role in the development of Latin jazz during the late 20th century. During the 1970s, both played alongside Eddie Palmieri and in Manny Oquendo's Conjunto Libre, and from 1980 to 2018 they directed the Fort Apache Band. From 2000 to 2018, Jerry González resided in Madrid, where he fronted Los Piratas del Flamenco and El Comando de la Clave. In October 2018, he died of a heart attack after a fire in his home in Madrid. Jerry González was born in 1949 in Manhattan, on 158th Street and 3rd Avenue, and moved to the Edenwald Houses in the Eastchester section of the Bronx at the age of 4. He was raised in a strong musical atmosphere, with the strains of Latin, Afro-Cuban and jazz music always in his ear, establishing his musical appreciation and molding his future work as an artist. His father, Jerry González, Sr., was a master of ceremonies and lead singer for bands during the Palladium era and sang with musicians like Claudio Ferrer. In junior high school he began playing trumpet and congas and jamming with local bands. After deciding this was his calling, González completed his formal studies at New York College of Music and New York University. He started his professional career playing with Lewellyn Mathews in the 1964 New York World's Fair. In 1970 he started playing congas with Dizzy Gillespie. With Gillespie's support and encouragement, González was able to fuse the African-based rhythms onto jazz elements without compromising the essence of either. The next year, González joined Eddie Palmieri's band until 1974. When he moved on to work with Conjunto Libre, the band led by timbalero Manny Oquendo and Jerry's brother, bassist Andy González. He and his brother Andy were the founders of the Conjunto Anabacoa and later of the charismatic grupo folclorico y experimental Nuevecano, with whom he recorded two LP albums, Concepts of Unity, 1974, and Lo Dice Todo, 1975. The band members were Jerry and Andy González, Frankie Rodríguez, Milton Cardona, Gene Golden, Carlos Mesta, Nelson González, Manny Oquendo, Oscar Hernandez, José Rodríguez, Gonzalo Fernández, Alfredo Chocolate Armenteros, Willy García, Heny Álvarez, Virgilio Martí, Marcelino Guerra, Rubén Blades, Orlando Buntilla Rios and Julito Collazo. He played with Tito Puente's ensemble, 1984 to 1999, McCoy Tyner's band, 1984 to 1990, and Jaco Pastorius's band, 1984 to 1987. In 1979, González published his first album as a leader, Yaomi Cure. Soon he formed his best-known group, the Fort Apache Band, which included his brother Andy and Kenny Kirkland, Sonny Fortune, Nicky Marrero, Milton Cardona, Papo Vázquez and the late Jorge Dalto. The ensemble's first two albums were recorded live at European jazz festivals, The River Is Deep in 1982 in Berlin and Hobart Isle in 1988 in Zurich. These were followed by their hit album, Rumba Para Monk, in 1988, earning them recognition from the French Academie du Jazz with the Jazz Record of the Year award. This was the record that caught the ears of the jazz community, and is still considered a stellar project. After that, the 15-member band was compressed into a sextet: Larry Willis, piano; Andy González, bass; Steve Berrios, drums; and Carter Jefferson, saxophone; and Joe Ford, saxophone. González and the band subsequently released Hearthstone's Sunnyside, 1990, and Moliendo Cafe, Sunnyside, 1991. These albums again demonstrated the band's ability to play Latin-inspired jazz with genuine sensitivity and virtuosity. After Moliendo Cafe, Carter Jefferson died and was replaced by John Stubblefield. They then released Crossroads in 1994 and Pensativo in 1995, each of which earned them Grammy nominations. The ensemble was awarded the Beyond Group of the Year by both Downbeat magazine readers and critics polls in 1995 and 1996. Gonzalez and group continued their creations on the 1996 album Fire Dance, recorded live at Blues Alley, and featuring interpretations of Thelonious Monk songs Let's Call This and Ugly Beauty, as well as original compositions. Their efforts were celebrated by winning a score of awards, including Best Jazz Group in Playboy magazine's readers' poll for 1997. In 1998 they swept the Latin Jazz category at the New York Jazz Awards, winning both the industry and journalist polls. In 1999 the group scored big with the critics and readers' polls for Beyond Group of the Year in Downbeat magazine. American edition of this album was called Jerry González y el Comando de la Clave, Sunnyside, 2011, was nominated to the Latin Grammy Awards as Best Latin Jazz Album and was voted Best Latin Jazz Album of the Year 2011 by jazz critics Ted Pankin, Downbeat magazine, and Doug Ramsey. In 2010, he was given the Latino of the Year award in the 100 Latinos Awards Madrid. His next releases were an album with the Spanish contrabass player Javi Colina, a duet album with the flamenco guitarist Nina Josel, and a Fort Apache album recorded live at the Blue Note in 2012 for the label Half Note Records. In the long run of his career, González performed and recorded with musicians such as Jaco Pastorius, Tito Puente, McCoy Tyner, Dizzy Gillespie, Che Baker, Eddie Palmieri, Cachao Lopez, Woody Shaw, Tony Williams, Larry Young, Freddie Hubbard, Brooklyn Philharmonic, Archie Shepp, Paco de Lucia, George Benson, Chico Farrell, The Beach Boys, Papo Vázquez, Ray Barretto, Bobby Pornetto, Chocolate Armenteros, Hilton Roos, Chico Freeman, Don Moy, Jose Chombo Silva, Rashid Ali, Baquito Drivera, Kenny Vance, Diego El Cigala, Enrique Mant, Santi Di Briano, and Steve Turr. He died at 69 years old.